pandemic hit me hard like it did everyone else. I caught the infection back in November and had to go into isolation. It felt like my whole world came to a sudden halt.
My home has turned into a workplace now, and office literally feels like home now. I think that's the 180 degree change that this pandemic has brought to my world.
I went from being this well-dressed business manager attending client meetings to this sweaty kitchen rag running to a Zoom call and ensuring the video is off. Barely make out between working hours, weekends, working days. It was a mess.
It's March 2021. A year since the breakout of a global pandemic, the likes of which no one has seen before. Inspired by the UN theme, Women in Leadership, Achieving an Equal Future in a COVID-19 World, we asked 10 women leaders in Cubist how they lead and thrive during a pandemic. More importantly, how did it alter their lives?
COVID pandemic has confined my whole world into a single building. That is my home. And with the addition of online classes for kids, it's more responsibilities on my plate now.
The initial days of the pandemic, there was a lot of fear, uncertainty, and helplessness all over the world. Nothing other than mere survival matter. It made me rethink and realign my priorities, appreciate the smallest of services and kind gestures. I became more aware of the feelings and well-being of the people around me, my family members and my colleagues.
Life shrunk to four walls, but I'm able to give my family more time when they really need me.
It made me realize the significance of work-life balance. We are conditioned to prioritize our work. But during the pandemic, I understood the importance of tea breaks, evening walks, and occasional get-togethers.
Initially, it felt strange to be at home all the time. There was a void, so I plunged myself into all kinds of activities and slowly got used to this new way of life.
Family is my world, and now I get to spend more time with my family. I have a greater work-life balance and work flexibility compared to pre-pandemic times.
My workplace changed from a large office with close friends to a small room in my house. I miss getting ready in the morning and driving to the office.
That I can cook 3 meals daily. I had people to help me in the kitchen all these years, and I had remained a weekend chef.
It taught me the power of mind. I was mostly asymptomatic, but I was deeply worried. I realized that the only way I could deal with it was by disciplining my mind, and I was able to do that.
It taught me I'm a multitasking kind of person and optimistic too.
It taught me that I can accommodate myself to any new situation, and I can maintain myself cool without compromising on any of my responsibilities.
No less than Wonder Woman.
I really learned how to manage family and work together. You can imagine the kind of pressure in my world, but I'm loving it.
I think I appreciate the simple things that we took for granted. Clean air, sunlight, time with family and friends, and my health.
That I can follow the concept of office hours. I normally ignore my health when it comes to work, but keeping proper hours has helped me devote some time to my well-being.
I used to take many little things for granted, like having a face-to-face conversation with friends and relatives, being able to visit loved ones, and having the freedom to go out. And yeah, I miss the hustle and bustle of our office pantry during lunch breaks.
The same superpower that every woman has got, multitasking.
I would say patience and perseverance.
That one superpower would be time management.
I have always been attached to my job, so I'd say that my love for my work is what keeps me going.
Multitasking and a lot of patience. And sometimes I just shut down and reboot myself.
I'm powerful on my own with a supportive partner. Stresses me at home. I feel even more powerful.
I have faith in God that He will see us through these trying times, and that it will all be over soon, and that we'll all come out the better for it.
To beat a global pandemic, we need 3 things: the common sense to strictly follow COVID protocols, trust in science, and hope for a better tomorrow.
I'm highly adaptable. That's always a message.
COVID has taught us to control our spending, especially for weddings and other social events. It'll be nice if we can all get used to eating home-cooked food, simple food which is much more healthy.
I would like to see people adopting a more sustainable lifestyle. There must be more focus on health, hygiene and the environment.
Focus more on health than wealth, of course.
Improved personal hygiene, better social responsibility, greater compassion for our fellow beings.
We thrive on our close relationships. I wish we would make it a point to keep in touch always and visit each other more once it's safe. I'd also like people to live healthier lives both mentally and physically.
Work flexibility should be there.
I hope people will have more work flexibility
and we should continue helping others.
One, people should have the choice to work from home. 2. The Indian IT crowd should learn how to manage time efficiently. 3. The concept of formal should change from shirts, kurtis, trousers, etc. to something presentable.
COVID was enough change, isn't it? Let's get back to pre-COVID time.
So we all know how distracting our phones can be because of social media. So it'd be good to turn off notifications and that way we can focus more on our work and our family time. To be stuck at home, we can always go out. We need to get some sunlight and our share of vitamin D, which will keep us healthy. So we should continue going out. It's very important at this time to connect with friends and family and colleagues. They need us as much as we need them. So always keep in touch.
While you're working from home, separate your household work and office work. Mixing these up can mess up your work-life balance. This might sound difficult, but believe me, it helps. Seek help, be it household work or office work. Don't try to take too much on your shoulders. Stay connected with your friends and family. It's important for your social and mental health.
Working wives and working mothers, make yourself a priority once in a while. You will thank yourself for it. Be organized, try to differentiate between your weekends, your working hours, your family time. This is very important. Get in touch with people just to catch up. You know, it needn't be something related to work. You can simply catch up with colleagues, have a cup of coffee virtually. Also, try to appreciate the little things in life. And when you get a chance, travel. Travel. It gives you a better perspective about yourself and about the world itself.
Don't be too hard on yourself. Find some time for self-care and entertainment. Life doesn't have to be perfect for us to be happy.
Maintain a healthy lifestyle. Take a 5-minute break after every 1 or 1.5 hours of work.
Don't feel isolated. Keep connecting virtually with your best buddies at work or maybe your teammates. Define your working hours. In that way, you can make sure that you will be having enough time for your family. And most importantly, you need to make sure that you have some me time, which is really, really important for every woman. Recollect whatever was your old hobbies and revive it and just re-energize yourself.
I have to follow strict work hours and focus on self-development, be personal or professional, both are important.
Give equal importance to work and self-care, build a stronger mind, and find happiness in whatever you're doing.
We may be rid of COVID someday, but the lessons we learned are here to stay.